Welcome back everyone to another Premiere Pro tutorial. Today I'll be showing you two ways you can make rotate your phone prompt or pop-up for IGTV videos or Instagram stories. It can be very useful when you want to upload a horizontal video to IGTV. And having a pop-up like this that lets the viewer know beforehand that the video is horizontal doesn't waste anyone's time and looks somewhat professional. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. The first method is extremely simple. So here I have my previous video clip in my project panel, which if you haven't watched yet, really cool glitch effect, highly recommend it, link in the description. So let's first create a new sequence and start fresh. I will make editing mode DSLR, 30 frames per second, and frame size 1080 by 1920, which is vertical IGTV compatible resolution. I think I'll leave everything else as they are and hit OK. Now I'll import my clip and keep existing sequence settings when prompted. As you can see, the video is horizontal and is not fitting my vertical view. So I'm going to rotate it by going into effect controls and changing the rotation to 90 degrees. Then I will import this GIF that I downloaded from Google Images. I will have it linked in the description below. And use it for the first few seconds. Yep. I wasn't lying when I said extremely simple. I'll move my clip around 3 seconds ahead. 3 to 4 seconds are enough for a viewer to look at it and know they're about to watch a horizontal video. I'm going frame by frame using my arrow keys. Trim it just a little bit after the animation ends. I'm going to make this into a loop so it plays for 3 seconds over and over. I will zoom in tight, hold down Alt, click and drag the clip to the right to make a duplicate. Make sure your snap is enabled, move it right next to the first clip so that there is a gap in between. I'm going to select both clips, hold down Alt again, click and drag both of them to the right so it loops one more time. As you can see, now we have a nice loop going on. And that's how you make rotation prompt with a GIF. If you want, you can add text to this as well, but I think it looks better the way it is. The next method is even simpler than this because we will be using an essential graphics template that I made in After Effects, which you can download from the link in the description below. It comes with a font file which you will have to install for this to work. For this you will 17.1. Older version does not support essential graphics templates, so if you're running an older one, now will be a good time to upgrade. If you do use this template, all I ask for is credits, so other creators can also use this free resource. But that's completely optional. So after you have downloaded my template, go to Window and enable Essential Graphics panel. Click on the Install Essential Graphics template icon and select the template you downloaded. You should now see the template in the Browse tab. To use it, all you have to do is drag and drop it into your timeline. In the Edit tab, you'll see some options you can play around with. Moving the slider to 2 will change the phone's color to white. Moving it to 1 will make it black. You can change the text and text color to whatever you like, or if you choose to, you can just leave it blank. To change its size, go to the Effects Control Panel and change Scale. And there you have it. Now you can let people know before the video starts that vertical video still suck. So that's it. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like. And if you're new here, subscribe and check out more videos on my channel. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Peace out. Today I'll be showing you two ways you can make rotate your phone prompt or pop-up.
The first method is extremely simple, which is what we do here on this channel.
So here I have my previous
So I'm going to rotate it by going into effect controls and changing the rotation to 90 degrees. Yep, I wasn't lying when I said extremely simple.
As you can see, now we have a nice loop. For this you will have to be using Premiere Pro to newer version.